What if you could take a photo of a chair and drop it straight into your SketchUp model as a 3D object without modeling anything yourself? Well, I tested a new AI tool called ArchSynth to do exactly that. And I'm going to show you how I turned product images into 3D models and imported them into SketchUp ready to render. I'll explain some best practices so that you can get the best results as well as ArchSynth's limitations. This isn't a walkthrough of ArchSynth. We are just going to concentrate on using the 3D Studio as this is something that will save time and impress clients. So if you're a designer using SketchUp, this could be a game changer. I also wanted to mention that ArchSynth gave me access to the Pro account for free, but I have no relationship with them other than that. So if you're into AI tools for design, hit subscribe. I've got more videos like this coming soon. So when you open up ArchSynth, you will come to this page and you can log in or sign up. I think there's a 7-day money-back guarantee, so you can definitely try it out. And if it doesn't work for you, then I think you can get your money back. But we're going to head over to the dashboard and we're going to focus on this tool here, which is the 3D Studio. There are firstly, three different models that you can choose from: the Lumen model, the Saturn model, the Nebula model. So most of my generations I've used in the Nebula model to get the best quality. You can also head onto the Explore page and you can see some of the models that have been created and download them and try them out if they're of interest to you. But what we're going to do is just have a look here at the 3D model. I created this model here. But one thing that I want to note is it outputs in a format called GLB. You may not be familiar with this. It's usually used in 3D object creation. So for example, in Blender, you can export as a GLB file. It stands for the GL Transmission Binary Format. And the reason it's used is, as you can see in this model here, it's actually got the textures. So when you download this, the textures are part of that file. So it's a relatively light file that you can then download into your SketchUp file, and it has all the texture and lighting information on it. So in this model, you can see it's actually maintained the lighting. So if you want to get rid of that, or you don't want to have any lighting, you have to be very, very careful with the image that you choose. Otherwise, you will get this type of information in your model. This may affect the outcome of your final render if you're using an external rendering engine like V-Ray or Enscape or Lumion. So once you've gone here, let's start a new model. So we can select a file and I'm just going to select one that I've already tried to use. So let's look at this mirror. And what I've tried to do in this walkthrough is try and generate a whole lot of different types of objects that you may put into a scene, like mirrors, like decorative items, like this vase, as well as furniture. Once you do that, you can change the privacy setting to private if you don't want it to appear in the Explore page. I'm sure I actually did this, but when I went through the Explore page, this model was there. Just make sure that nothing that is proprietary is uploaded to this model. You can play with the different seeds. I've been using seed 42. You can change the seed number to create a new 3D model from the same image. The best practice is, if you don't like the output that you're getting, then do change the seed number and then you can just randomly assign a seed. So let's just use this seed. I was using seed 42 for quite a while and I actually really liked the results that came out. You can see it takes a number of seconds to generate. So we'll fast forward and you'll meet me once it's been generated. So you can see here, this is a fairly simple generation, but if we circle around, we can see it is quite accurate. If we look though at the original image, so I'm just gonna hop into Canva, you can see that they haven't got the shape quite right. So I guess once you've uploaded it into SketchUp, you can play around with the model. If you're a Blender person or in Fusion 360, you can again, you know, play a little bit more with the meshes to get the exact shape that you want. If you just want to have something that is relatively close to the original image to give your client an idea of what it might look like in that image, then this is really quite enough. So let's hop back, and what you can do is then download this model and it will appear in the GLB format. And you can save that to your desktop. And then now we're going to hop into SketchUp and take a look at importing the model. Before we start looking at uploading it to the model, I want to have a quick chat about the images that you choose. From my experience, and I'll be showing you a little bit later, when you are choosing the images, if you can get an image that is side on so that you can see the full shape of that image, it's better. Now, when you hop into ArchSynth, you can see that you can choose either a single view or a multiple view. Now, a multiple view allows you to drag and drop multiple views of the same image. I haven't found that there's a huge difference in the images, but what I've actually found that is important is when you are looking or choosing images to upload, to choose ones where you can actually see the shape. So for example, so let's have a look at some side tables. And I found that if you choose images that are on the side, the results are much more satisfactory. And I think it's basically because the model's trying to sort of guess what a 360 degree view of that table looks like. This table, for example, where you can see this part of the image, either leg is quite thin. As designers or someone viewing the table, we know that it's rounded in shape, but ArchSynth doesn't know that. Whereas if you choose an image where you can really see the shape of the image, it tends to work much better. Another tip is to choose images without a background. So you can jump into a tool like Canva, and you can see here, I've actually created a whole lot of images to test. And some of these were good and some of these weren't. For example, this image where you can see that the table is taken from the front and you can't see a lot of detail with how deep it is. Now, this was not a very successful generation. I couldn't get it to work. This chair, for example, when I gave it this image, it did a lot better than when I gave it this image. And I think the conclusion is you can't see the other leg. So it got really confused and created a model where it was in the round. So I'll show you that in a little bit. You can take any image here, and if you upload the file like this and then drop it in, and I try and make it as big as possible and then use the background remover tool. You can use Photoshop or a free tool like Background Remove that you can find online to remove the background. Once we've got that, let's hop back into ArchSynth and generate that image. So we'll just create a single view again and we'll select the file. So you can see here, it's got a little bit confused. It's not perfect. And we can try another seed and regenerate. So let's just change it to another scene and generate it again. Okay, so this is much better. Again, it's quite an experimental process. So let's download this model and pop it into SketchUp. This is a SketchUp model that I've already started populating. First of all, it will actually import directly into SketchUp, but I suggest you use this plugin, which is a Sketchucation Universal Importer plugin. It's completely free. You can just download it and then use the extension manager to upload it into your SketchUp program. You'll head into SketchUp and you'll see the Universal Importer under the extensions tab and go import a 3D model. So here's our 3D model that we generated. And you can see the source model. It has, this is the dimensions. I haven't really seen a huge amount of difference between these, but I'm using meters, so I'm going to hit OK. Now you'll see it has 20,908 faces. And I've set it to reduce the polygon count. So it will actually tell you what your target face. So I want to change this to, let's say, 6,000 and hit OK. And so this is the advantage in using the importer. Now you can see it's turned up with quite a lot of polygons. So I'm going to just soften and smooth those edges. And I'm just going to use this to just smooth the edges a little bit. And let's just move it into place. So let's move it into place and just scale it to approximately the right size. Let me just check. That looks about right. There we have it. And you can see it's quite a complex shape. And this is pretty much done in real time. So you already have a model in a few minutes. Now, if you have a look through, you can see here are a few different models. Now, this was something that I downloaded from 3D Warehouse. I actually did try to generate a model from this and it was not very successful. So again, you have to be very, very careful with the kinds of models that you're choosing and also the view of that model. So let's just head back into some of the models that I've created. Some ones, like for example, I use the multi-prompt with these two images, but actually this image turned out better. So again, it's experimentation and changing the seed. I tried this table here and I started off in an early version of giving it just this one image. And you can see if you go back to this, it actually has this triangular leg, which you cannot see in this image. So when the model was created, it actually created two of the same and put an extra leg there. These are some of the small problems that you may come across when you're creating model. When I gave it this image here, the model was a lot more effective. Whereas when I gave it this image here, if you look at the 3D model, it actually created it as a circle. So this is, now I could have tried a different seed and generated it again and maybe it would have worked. I do recommend that you try a number of times and experiment with the different seeds until you find a model that you like. And finally, an image like this, as I said, if you view it in 3D, it was unable to get that top. It sort of got the legs, not particularly well, and I don't know where these came from. It did get the idea of the legs. Again, this could be the angle. I think if it had been taken from an angle like this, the result would have been better. And just a note about the files. I haven't tried this in Revit. It's working pretty well in SketchUp. If you download the file as a GLB file and then convert it to an OBJ file, it should actually work in Revit. You can use something like SketchUp or Blender to import the file and then convert it to an OBJ file and then bring it into your Revit model, and this should work. But as I said, I haven't tested it myself. So here's just a side by side that you can look. The original is here, and as we are looking at it, it is reasonably accurate. It's got the shape of the tabletop and it looks pretty good in our SketchUp model. So this is pretty great if you don't want to make a furniture model from scratch, particularly something that is as complex as this. The models really were created in minutes and they are, you know, relatively accurate enough to give a client a good impression of what a particular piece of furniture would look like in a space. So this is the final result inside SketchUp, and you can see these pieces are modeled directly from product images for early client presentations, quick models, and VR walkthroughs. This is a very, very effective tool and probably worth the price if you make a lot of models. If you want to try ArchSynth for the time that it might save you, it's pretty affordable. Remember, it can take a number of hours to just create one complex model. So students can use it for around $9 a month. And the pro plan, which is what I got access to, is $24 a month. And there's a business plan at $199 a month. The pro plan gives you the ability to make 1,000 models, which is quite a lot. And you may have to spend a little bit of time testing. So if you're doing a lot of design, you might need it. I've linked everything in the description below. I don't have any relationship with them other than them allowing me to try it out for free. So if you use that link, you'll go straight to their website. If you're curious about AI tools for design, hit that like button and let me know in the comments what tools you're using or what you'd like me to test next. Thanks again to ArchSynth for giving me free access. I'll be testing a lot of AI design tools, so make sure you're subscribed. If you want to see more AI tools for interior designers right now, I'd watch this next video right here where I walk through 20 plus ways that you can use ChatGPT's image generation in your interior design business.